And it's on my heart today to say a prayer. To say a prayer. And if you want to pray with me, you know, you are welcome to do that. Pray with me in this prayer that I'm about to pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Lord, we thank you for allowing us to see another day, God. Another day of grace, another day of mercy, Father God. Another day of favor, God. Lord, we don't ever want to take for granted of your love. We don't want to take for granted of your grace and your mercy on our lives, God. Hallelujah, God. Lord, we are forever thankful. We are thankful for your love. We are thankful, Father God, for all that you are doing for us and through us, God. We are thankful, Father God, that you have brought us a mighty long way, God. And we know that you are bringing us even closer to you, Jesus. Lord, I ask, God, that you save those who have not accepted you in their hearts, God. But they must accept your son, Jesus, into their hearts, God, into their minds. They must surrender. They must repent. And they must accept you, Father God. Hallelujah, for a new life, for a better life in the name of Jesus, God. Because, Father God, we know that when one plant, the other water, and God, you do the increase, Jesus. And, Father God, I come to you today, God, to help the grieving hearts of those who have lost a loved one that was senseless to murder, or someone that have taken their own life, God, and the family members are mourning right now. Whatever the case is, Father God, or if it's a divorce, or if it's a financial problem, or if it's a problem, God, wherever it is, at home, at work, on the job, in the business, with a client, with a contractor, with a contract, with a legal situation, or whatever the case is, Father God, we know that you are an awesome God and that you shall fix it and you will fix it, and that you are the comforter. Hallelujah, God, that you come and you comfort, God. You give us peace, God, in the midst of the storm, Jesus. And we thank you, Father God, for all that you are doing in our lives. And we don't ever want to say thank you, Jesus. We don't ever want to forget to say thank you, God. We don't ever want to wake up every morning and not praise your name. We don't want to ever get up in the morning, God, and just call it luck, because it's not luck. There's no such thing of luck, but we know that it is a such thing of blessings. And we are thankful for the blessings, Father God. We are thankful for the food that you put on our table. We are thankful, Father God, for everything that we eat that you provide us with, God. We know that your word says that you shall supply all of our needs according to your riches and glory through Christ Jesus, God. We know that we look up to the hills, that which cometh our help, and our help cometh from you, O God. Hallelujah, Jesus. We know that you are the creator, Father God. We know that you are our beginning and our end, Father God. We know that we are here for a reason and for a purpose, oh God. We know that you have given us a gift to do your will, Father God. We know, Father God, that there is purpose behind every gift in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. And Lord, I want to say, Father God, that to all of those who are in agreement with me in prayer, God, I ask, God, that you do something in their lives. Those who are watching this video right now, that God has something for you. God has a word for you. And God wants you to be encouraged. God knows that there's changes that is coming for you. God sees what your heart is grieving over. God sees what your heart's desires are. God knows, and he sees, and he's above, and he knows every little detail. He knows every little detail of our lives. Hallelujah. He knows it. He knows every how many hairs we have on our head. He knows what he knows, even the birds in the air, what they need. If he can be so detailed and being able to provide food for every little bird that flies, and for every little insect that he created, everything, you got to understand, he created everything. But if he is so such a God who is so detailed enough to know our needs, why are we worried about what are we going to eat tomorrow? What are we going to eat today? Why are we so worried about what are we going to wear? Why are we so worried about the things that God has already provided for us? He only asked us to believe in him. He only asked us to trust in him. Why are we so worried and stressed about the things of this life when we don't even know if we're going to be here tomorrow? Why are we so worried about if this prayer is going to come through? Why are we so worried about it if we're supposed to be a person of faith? Why are we worried if we have faith in God? When we doubt God, when we doubt our prayers, And when we doubt the fact that we know God can come through, we doubt God. We become an enemy of God when we doubt Him. So stop doubting God. Stop doubting that He's not going to come through for you. Because it is by His will and it's by your faith. It is your faith that touches God's heart. Hallelujah. But most of all, it is by your praise with thanksgiving. Hallelujah, Jesus. The word says to be anxious. Do not be anxious for anything. But with prayer and supplication, make your request known unto God. Hallelujah, God. You are to make your request known to Him, but at the same time, thank Him. Say, hallelujah, I thank You, Father God, that even though this situation is not going right, hallelujah, Father God, that I know that You are going to work it out in Your will, in Your season, God. It is through Your will, it is in Your will that it is going to work out. And I don't want to be before You long, but I just had to say this prayer. I had to say this prayer this morning, that God touch our hearts, our minds, our soul. He deliver us and He will restore us. God, keep us. Keep us, Father God, in everything that we are going through, whatever it is that we are going through inside, within ourselves, within our souls, that is private. Keep us, God. Do not allow us to go astray and do not allow us to ever doubt and ever doubt You, oh Father God. And I pray that those who do not believe in God, that God, You will show them a sign and that You will transform them. But first of all, you must have a renewed mind in order to be transformed. And God, that I pray that You renew their minds, God, and You soften their hearts, God, to receive You. In Jesus' name I pray. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, You are blessed. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. You better know this. God bless you.